Hi students, welcome to week 11. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go through week 11 assignments. There's two assignments. So I went through our class here, click on content, and then I'm going to click on submit week 11 assignments. By the way, week 10 assignments I do tonight, which is Wednesday, okay? So there's two assignments under week 11. The very first one is discussion. So they are usual, I'm going to have you post one initial posting responding to the assignment, and we're going to talk about which is about formal and informal communication in the workplace. So we're gonna talk about that and give you some tips of how to get this done. So this is a discussion. You will have to get two postings back to another two classmates. So total of postings supposed to be three. Your initial posting answering the questions, and then the second and the third one, you're supposed to pick two other students that will be responding to their initial posting. Okay, so instead of responding to one, this time you have to respond to two. All right, and then the second assignment, I'm going to go back to this one. The second assignment is linking recommendations. So this is where you have to write a recommendation paragraph for another person that you know in LinkedIn, and this can be a student that you feel comfortable with. You're not going to share it with another student or the other person. This is just for the assignment, the purpose of the assignment. If you do want to, you know, end up sharing this with someone else, that's just completely up to you, okay? It's in a Word document, and you will submit it through here. And I'm going to talk to you more about it. So let's talk about the very first discussion, 6.1 formal and informal systems. So this is where you're going to do some reading, and you are going to start kind of getting ready when you go to the internship. The whole assignment itself, and I need you to read this, is about formal and informal communication in the workplace. So I did a PDF here, and I also have you, I'm gonna have you watch this video, which will kind of identify some of those concepts in terms of what is formal and what is informal communication in the workplace, to start thinking about how you're gonna handle yourself in terms of communicating with others once you get to that internship, okay? So just real quick, because you're going to answer some questions. The questions will be, again, you're going to do a written response. That will be your initial posting. And then you're going to do two other student posts. That means you're going to respond to them, okay? Now, there's three questions that I need you to kind of answer within that initial posting. And the first one is, in what ways my workplace conversations, informal and informal, will impact your internships, okay? We're gonna talk about what is the difference right now, so you can start thinking about what that may affect you. And then the second one, how might you use these systems, which means, you know, the formal and informal, to your advantages of your internship. And then the last one, are there ways that you may be able to, at disadvantage in dealing with workplace communication system as an intern? So we're gonna start giving you some feedback here. So for example, I'm gonna open my formal and informal PDF here, and I'll just type this, and I went through a few things. I described what it is in organization communication, what is formal and informal, and of course we're gonna talk about advantages and disadvantages of formal and informal communication so that you get ready to answer those questions, okay? So for example, this picture. So the formal communication means when you have a meeting with more than, you know, two people, and you're sitting, you know, maybe the meeting's at 8:30 a.m. You all sitting there, and you do have an agenda. So you go through the items within the agenda. Someone is taking minutes, that type of thing. Having this communication back and forth in terms of whatever the items on the agenda and what you guys need to accomplish. Okay. Now that is formal communication. Informal communication is when you're still at the workplace, however you went to get some coffee or water, whatever the case is, and you're still talking about, you know, work things related, but in more, you know, easygoing type of environment. That is called the informal communication. Obviously, there's always advantages and disadvantages of both formal and informal communication. So the one disadvantage that I can tell you right away is that sometimes informal communication can turn into gossip, and that's why you need to be careful. Yes, we want to have communication that is relaxed and friendly, but we don't want to go over the line where we start talking about other people within the workplace. So we need to be careful. So here's some formal and informal communicators. I'm not going to read it, but I want you to read this. There's different the structure in the organization. Now think about it. If you, for example, have a meeting with the CEO, the president of the actual company that you're going to be doing this internship, of course you want to have a formal communication. Now, if you're meeting someone who is this person that you kind of working closely with the entire day because obviously you're getting trained, there's a point where you don't want to be so formal. You want to be more a little bit more friendly, which means you're going to have more of that informal communication with that person just so you both can be relaxed and easy, friendly going, so you can go through the day and be more comfortable, right? Because at the end of the day, we want to be comfortable where we are. But keeping in mind that one of its advantage was that can step where you start sharing your personal information, your personal life, gossiping and that type of thing. And so that's what informal communication can have disadvantages. And I think if we can balance things out and not go over that aspect of getting too personal, in people's life and sharing too much in the workplace, then it will be fine just to keep the conversation friendly and more relaxed, and it will be more of informal communication. So we need to be careful. So I'm not going to go through the whole thing, but there's a lot of information here. I give you some a lot of the advantages and disadvantages of both informal and formal to help you. So back to here, and then there's this video. So then here, you're just gonna answer these questions. And if you have any questions, once we meet tomorrow morning as well, but if you have any questions, you email me and I can schedule another Skype meeting just one-on-one, okay? But make sure you read the PDF, make sure you go through the video, okay? So to help you answer those three questions. Now, back to the linking recommendation. So the linking recommendations, you're gonna write maybe a solid paragraph, maybe two paragraphs. As obviously, the whole purpose of getting a recommendation from anyone is because this person know us and want to say something nice and good things about ourselves, because we're going to publish this through a very public website, which is LinkedIn. Now, for the purpose of the class, you're just going to write it in a Word document and you're going to submit it through this link, okay? Now, if you want to share it with that person that you're going to write the recommendation to, then you are more than welcome, but you do that on your own, okay? So I'm going to click in here. The first thing is to log into LinkedIn to identify one class peer or whoever you want to write a recommendation to, and you can do that, okay? My recommendation to you is to also go through a few things. For example, go on LinkedIn and look at people's recommendation. A lot of people get different recommendations. See how they wrote it, okay? See what are the things that they're saying. But I'm going to go through this link, which you can do that as well. And what happens here is it's giving you the 5-minute guide to amazing writing when it comes to recommendations. So here, the step one will start with a knockout line, okay? Something that you know about this person. And they give you different examples, describe your relationship with this person, share a standout trait, meaning you can share some of the soft skills and hard skills about this person. Moving forward, add a touch of personality. People have different personalities, so the person may have an amazing personality, maybe very outgoing, approachable, so you can talk about those things. And then you want to end it with a very solid recommendation, okay? And then they give you some, excuse me, some examples here. And then there's a little guide over here. But one of the recommendations that I will give is that you can actually just go through LinkedIn and see some of the recommendations that people got already, just to give you kind of like, a feeling of what a recommendation looks like, okay? All right, so I described the two assignments starting for week 11. I will send you also an invite for the Skype. If you have any questions, just let me know, all right? Thank you so much.